No, a shell. Oh, yeah. Life is so much sweeter when you can just pick up shells. Hello, everyone, and welcome back again to Divinity Original Sin 2. We have a few markers here and there showing something that might be very important for us to go check out. So I thought about doing that. There's a lot of people down here we haven't talked with yet, so we should probably get on with it. But first of all, I would like to let you know that I am recording this video back to back with part 5 just before, which means that if you've written any comments or anything at all, I have not read it yet. But hopefully I will have for next time, if it is, maybe, I have no idea. And forgive my voice, because we are all having a big stupid cold here in this house, so that means I'm running out of breath constantly, having to cough and all these other lovely things that comes with a cold. Isn't life just joyous? Anyway, let's talk with Sahela. The young girl's eyes are covered, but she turns towards you when you approach. She smiles as though she recognizes you, though she couldn't have seen your face. Ah, hello. So much you suffer. So much suffering you have and you make. Does causing pain stop yours? Ask how she knows this, tell her it's none of her business, ignore her remark. Ask how she knows about that. I see it up before my eyes. Tell her you're only getting started. The blood of your enemies is like a balm for your soul. Dear one, no, your anger will. But I should not say. You must discover for yourself. She takes your hand. I wish you only healing. Tell her you found the elf Amoiro and have struck a deal to have him freed. Oh, you help him. Your open heart surprises even me. Say you're happy to help? You bless me. You bless us all. Hey, I want to talk with her again. Say you're looking for a way out of Fort Joy. Her eyebrows shoot up. There can be a way. Amoiro knows. But he is gone. Do you see him? He knows how to leave. Yeah, ask if you've met such a man. She nods quietly as though she knows this all along. He is caught by those who hurt her. I wish so much for his return, but he tells you what you seek, and he tells you what you seek. A way out. Promise you'll help her, friend. You bring me great peace. Thank you, my friend. I miss him very much. I see something that helps. I see a lizard. He is a lizard of my dreams, a far feeling. You do not free Amoiro without him. Say you have a few questions? Yes, please ask. Ask why she covers her eyes. Oh, I do not cover my eyes. I cover the place they used to be. They are gone now, taken. But I see all the same. Ask who took her eyes and why. He is a very blind man. He sees things, but not truth. Not love or joy. I feel very sorry for him. You understand when you meet him, after you escape. Ask why she and the others are holed up in this dark cave. Dank cave. It's safer here. We make no trouble for Griff. He makes no trouble for us. Ask how she and Amoiro came to Fort Joy. I knew we must be here. I'm not sure how much to explain. You're here, and so we are here. Okay, well, I'll take my leave. Well, she is quite the special one, isn't she? So any other interesting people we kind of come across? How about Elodie? Thank you for your help with that thug. Our kind of few here. We must help each other. Tell her it was nothing. You cannot stand by while a man takes your sister's freedom. Ask if she knows of any way out. Ask if you'd like to know who's in charge around here. In this case, we trust Sahela. She is young, but she sees. She knows more than we know. In the camp, the brute Gruff rules. He who gives the bread has the power. As he knows the way out, he hath no escapes. The only way out is through the magisters, through their cure. Thugs I can stand, but I fear the magisters. Ask how she came to Fort Joy. It gives me great pain. I'm with my family. We are making beautiful magic. We are healing a tree cut down with great violence. The magisters come. My family runs, but I fall. My son looks back. I shout to him to run. I am taken. Wait, before you go. I am not here without your help. I do not forget this. For you are prize. I save it for a special occasion, but I can think of no finer occasion than this. Thank you. What did we just get? A head? Did we get a severed head? I could think of a nicer thing. Well, I'm not sure. We can eat it. Should we eat it? Should we just, like, chow down on a severed head? Or should we save it for a celebration if we ever get out this place? Maybe we should just save it. Because we want to have a feast. When we get out of this place, or if we ever get out of this place, we want to be able to chow down on a severed head and go, yum yum. Because that's just what you can do. Now, how to get out of here again? Oh, here. Yeah. There we go. So we're back in the ghetto, and we should probably go and see if we can free our friend. Let's try and go this way. Da, 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 da. Okay, this is where the magisters are hanging out. And he was through here? I think so. Noozy, hello. Oh, there he is. Is that cage just completely bugging up now again? Yeah, it is. Okay, well, let's try and go here. Okay, and then have a talk with Camp Boss Grief. Griff. Griff glances from his blade to you and back again. Say you found his oranges, or more accurate, his Dradane. Spare the indignation and hand it over. Now. Give him what change about you prefer cash. Tell him you're not going to feed his habit. Well, let's give him what he's asked for. Good girl. Looks like everything's accounted for. Now the important question. How's the thief? Who's the thief? Turn him in. This is their quarrel, not ours. This grief is nothing but a thug. Don't give Stingtail up that easily. I don't want his blood on my hands. Griff would kill a fellow over a priest. Giving up is no better than murder. Some truths are better kept under one's hat. Ha, I am right cuffed to have my supplies back, so I'm gonna give you one last chance. Tell me who you found them on, or you're gonna have to answer to me, my knife, and each one of my people. Oh, and your little elven friend won't make it out alive either. Hold your ground. Oh, you must think I'm playing with you. I don't play. Hand him over. Okay, here we go, people. Big battle ahead. Oh, yo, yo, and what level are they? Level 3. Yo, 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 yo. There, we also have one there. Got Griff. He's the boss. He's got 73 health. He's got 60. And we have another one upstairs. Got 64. Two here, 64. Okay, how are we gonna do this first? Well, I think we are going... See, that's an archer. Okay, so can we have him jump over an enemy? Nope. He can only do it with him. But I'm not sure if that's good enough. Can we throw a poison cloud? This way. There we go. I don't know. I'll save if it is this doesn't go that well, okay? You'll have to bear with me now. Borrow action points from your next. Encourage them, increasing their main attributes. Let's just see how it goes, okay? Okay, well, there I encourage, and I'm gonna have him move here. Got her coming down. Oh, she is ranged. Uh-oh. Poor Sibyl. So we got this little woman here. She can return vitality. So let's heal Sibyl before she gets struck again. And let's have her. He's the boss. Try and... what can we do? Chilling them? Or jump? Let's do that here. Yeah. And then let's have her move here. Away from him. Uh-oh. Oh, this is really gonna be a big bad fight, I think. Well, we're just gonna have to try and see how it goes, okay? Oh. I want to take out some of these ads first, though. So do I have this one? Rush forward. No. Okay, that's not gonna work. Fire a thing that's gonna... Paths interrupted. Inferno. That's also not... It's very short ranged, isn't it? Range grow. Let's not sacrifice our thing yet. Okay, we can blind him. No, let's not do that. Let's do this one instead. There we go. Oh, she lost health with that as well. Oh no. So he can do a flaming thing. Increase. Or do some poison. Smash your weapon into the ground. I don't want to hit him though. So no, we can't do that. Can we do this? Oh, he's kind of in the way of everyone, isn't he? Yeah, they're all in the way. But if I do like this. Like that. Oh, crap. That was not good. Sorry, everyone. We're kind of dying here. Okay, so we have to get out of here. We can go behind here. There we go. Okay. And then end that turn. Uh-oh. Don't kill her! Oh, she died. That's not good. Well, let's just try and see what happens, though. It might be a waste of an episode, but... I just want to learn. So, I see she has that one on cooldown, so we want to move her over here at least. And then... Oh, crap, I can't do that now. Encouraged, we're already encouraged. So, how about we help kill that one? Oops! Okay, this is definitely not going very well. I think I'm gonna have to redo this, just a second. Yeah. We are too slow, too weak to do this. This is definitely not our thing. No, we can't do this. This is too much. So, after having many failed attempts at doing this fight here, because every time you talk with this grief guy, well, let's just say you kind of end up having to fight him, Hilda, a needle, someone up here as well, and one down here, and they are way too powerful for me to handle. That is really annoying. So, we have to figure out other things to do. I ran in, just intimidated by some... What's this then? We have to figure out something else to do. Med Magister wants to find an inmate named Maigo. Maigo, okay, we can also try and do that. Da da da. Okay, so, before, let's not talk with him again, because that will, yeah, mind your manners, you bum. I'm not really sure what we should do now. We can turn that guy in, but I don't find that I want to find another way of doing this, because that just seems very bad. If you can say it like that. So hopefully we will be able... Oh, autosave. Okay. Why are we autosaving? I just hope that we... Oh! Crocodiles! Cool. Let's see if we can at least beat them. There we go. Fight. Big crocs. Okay. Need some XP here, people. So we have her. Okay. No, we start with him. Okay, cool. I don't want him to go in there, so he can start out encouraging people. And I want him to retreat. Los, she can. Let me see, she has 2 action points for going here. And then she can target too far away. Okay. What can she do? Resurrection scroll. Throw some stun. There we go. Oh, what? No! Teleporting it! Oh, that looks so cute! Oh, that's not cute. Stop biting me. But that looked... I don't know why, but it just looks so cute. Big fat crocodile flying up in the air. What are they doing? I didn't know they were gonna be able to do magic. Oh no. That's not good. Okay, so we're gonna do a battering ram here. There we go. And does she have any action points? Yeah, she can go a bit. See, I wanted to go back. Oh, attack of opportunity. Oh god, don't tell me she's already dead now. Well, that was a short thing. So he... I want them to retreat a bit further back, because they seem to be some hard crocs here. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. Yeah, just go here, end your turn. Uh-oh, Lowe's, you definitely can't take that on. You have to run with them all. Who do we have left there then? Oh no, he's laying there, that's not good. Okay, Sybil is dead. Seriously, I thought we were gonna take these on so easily. But no. What are they going for? Ay, ay, ay. Okay. So maybe he should just... No, can I go a bit back? Can I do that? Okay, so that one's burning now. And fill a character's physical armor. Can I do that? Oh, she's too far away. They're all too far away. But I can do it on myself. And then step one, step back. And turn. Is everyone far enough away from that one? I can make it go that way. No, I don't think I can. Can you use the scroll of resurrection on her? Oh, she's too far away. Okay, then not. What else can we do? Well, let's have him go a bit further away. What is he stuck with here? What is that? Slowed. Okay, yeah. There we go. The Red Prince is down. Oh no. god, this is not good. Oh, Lowe's. Poor Lowe's. Oh, that just sucks. So we can't even do this proper, guys. This is a bit frustrating. This is a very annoying episode for me. I'm trying to do so much battling and it just keeps really going bad. Very bad. I just want to use that oil barrel. So yes, we found out there was a reason behind this autosave. We are gonna get our asses kicked or bombs kicked if we continue any further down here, because there are three big dangerous crocodiles. And they will really kick our bombs so hard. So yet again, another fight. I have literally done nothing this whole episode now, but fiddle around with different battles and losing them all. I don't know if it's my combat skill that really is just very bad in this game, or I'm missing out on something, how to do it proper, but it is very frustrating. And all just because I wanted to spare a poor guy from dying and trying to get some XP. Let's see what Margot here has to say. The woman looks out of a gently lapping waves. Out on the gentle edge, she seems totally at peace, but as you approach, she turns to you with a cheerful smile. I haven't seen you around here before. New? What's it called? Tell her you just arrived. Well, don't worry too much if you had a hard time settling in. It takes a while to get used to the place. You here alone? Say, I've been lucky enough to make some close ties. She gives you a long look. You keep them friends of yours close, eh? Some of us haven't gotten anyone at all anymore. Not much in this world. Someone you love can't make it better. Thank her. Ask why she's here alone. Used to be, I had a family, a husband and a little boy. We were healers. Source was in our blood. Then they brought us here. I couldn't stop them from taking my boys from me when they did. Reckon they were cured, maybe even released. Don't know why the Reds didn't take me too. Now I'm just waiting for them to call my name, waiting and remembering. Ask her to tell her more what her boys were like. Her eyes sparkle. Kind of you to ask. Stefan, he was my little one, smart as a whip and no less wicked. And my husband, he was called Felix. He was an expert healer. Could fix a broken bone in a short minute. Take a seat in the sand and listen. She tells for some time about birthdays, about Felix's prickly beard, about the skunk Stefan once dragged home for a pet. Joy radiates from her as she remembers. She places a warm hand on your shoulder. What a gift. What a gift to think of them. I'd like to give something to you, too. A family recipe, one of Felix's best. He'll be happy to know it went to such a warm soul. Take care of yourself, you're here. You're a sweet one. Oh, thank you. So what did we get? A restoration scroll? That can be very handy, especially considering how crappy those battles I just tried went. Oh, a shell. Oh, yeah. Life is so much sweeter when you can just pick up shells. It's worth it, I tell you. It's very definitely worth it. Anything else we can do around here? Kind of getting a bit stuck, I think. Ooh, Maul, who is that? Here you are. I wonder what keeps you. Tell me your tale. Note that he still speaks as elves do. Ask what he means. You never met before. Take number 3. Their tongue is not my tongue. You may speak of then and when. I do not. I refuse to learn their strange speech. Ask what he means. You never met. Ask him what he wants to know. Start from the beginning. Start from where you come. Say you came from a place not far. Recall the far off land which you travel. Claim your origins are too strange to believe. Number 1. I see, I see. Now tell me more. Tell me what you do. Tell me what you find. You seek to see a debt repaid. You seek to make amends. Second one. I understand. Now tell me how your story ends. I hope to find something you've lost. I hope the burdens will be lifted. I see it in your shoulders, the weight you carry. I hope your wish comes true. Take this rope, it's a gift. It's common, but it helps you lift burdens. Thank you for the gift. It's nothing. Many fragments swirl on my shore. See what I gather? So what does he gather, indeed? A skill book? Huh? A fortified skill book? Cast a magical... that does la 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 la. Fossil. What about Lowe's here? She doesn't have Geomancer? Okay. Repair hammer, empty grenade, soap. Bowstring. Sharp rock, lockpicks. Sticky oil, that's quite nice though. But I don't think Lowe's has any attributes for that. Anyway, take your leave. Let me just check out Lowe's. What does she have? No Geomancer. Geomancer? So that is indeed. I thought someone else had it. Oh yeah, he does. So he could actually learn it, but he kind of has his skill bar full, and we'd have to figure out which skills do we then want to get rid of instead. Shell. Give me my shell. Da 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 da. Whisperwood. Okay. What's this? Yeah, that's him. I can't help him right now. Not without getting him killed, I guess. I'm really not well getting this guy killed. It's can't we ask him to run away? Don't mention my name to Griff. No, I know. But I don't know how to do it without that. I just... ooh, bone pile. What's this? Wool, okay. Anything else up here? No. Da, da, da. So I wonder how we can progress without getting our dear lizard friend killed and killing those crocodiles as well. I just have a feeling we need to get a bit higher level before we can really do any big battles and stuff. What is down here? Now I definitely need to save before we go any further, because saving before really helped my... oh no. Don't auto-save! It's always bad when it auto-saves. Oh, shells! Oh, what is this? Maiko! Maiko has been busy. Hello there. An inmate called Maiko. Level 4. He's weak though. Whoa-oh. The creature heaves through lips gummed with human gore. It turns to you with great effort. Pain apparent in every movement and madness screams from its wide bloodshot eyes. Oh God. You. Quite lost. Careful or they'll crush your wires. Now, a little query. Where grows the yarrow? Quickly now, for I haven't much time. Sorry, but you can't help him. Step a bit back, lay a hand on your weapon. Take the yarrow plant from your pouch and offer it to him. The creature gingerly takes the plants into his bloodied hands. He runs his fingertip over the white flower. His panting breath slows. Dear darling child. Hello, yarrow girl. Can it really be you? Let's see. Ask him why he was looking for that flower. The creature cleanses the plant tightly, his breath quickens. He seems liable to lunge at you at the drop of a pin. You wouldn't understand. A father's pride. A father's love. The creature begins to weep. Fast, silent tears spill from his eyes as he clutches the little cluster of flowers to his heart. For you, my ring, part of me. Name of Maigo, thank you. Oh. Okay. So, the murderous geist. It had a pacifying effect. I found Magister Yara who wants to find an inmate named Maigo. Okay. Can we loot your lovely mutilated corpses? What about this one? Okay. What is it? Say you'd like to ask him a few questions. Go. Say it seems as though someone has interfered with him in body and mind. Does he know what happened? Oh, ask if you can remember his name. Name of Maigo came out of Arx. My daughter's a magister. Pretty haired Yarrow girl. She doesn't know about all this though. Don't you dare blame her, pretty haired Yarrow girl. Seems someone has interfered with him? Told you, didn't I? They cross my wires, hammer goes clang, and when the worms crawl in. If you're referring to the hammer, the right hand of Bishop Alexander? Clang, clang, horrible old sadist, fills my brain with holes. The devil lives inside her. Believe you me. Okay. Well, maybe we should go and talk with that person that actually wanted us to find Maigo. We can at least try and do so, I think. But I think I'll leave that for next time because I have a little girl that's waking up upstairs and I've been doing this for quite a long time now, all these matches. I hope this episode won't be too short because of that. But I'll try and edit it together in a nice way, I hope. I hope. So I'll catch you the next time. Give it a like if you liked all my failed attempts here and there. And if you would like to see more, subscribe. And I hope to see you next time then, everyone. Have a great day and take good care of yourself. Goodbye!